comic book fans, welcome back to Comic Book Corner 2.0. And guys, today we're talking about episode number 2 of The Walking Dead, which is otherwise known as Infected. That's right. Last week, I missed the season premiere on its actual premiere night. I didn't watch it till Tuesday, and this was the introduction of a season that really had nothing to do with the comic book. So I'm sitting there scratching my head going, what can this really be about? I mean, we were left cliffhanging with that kid Patrick who was, you know, it looked like he was sick, and then he passed out and banged his head and looked like he like died, and then he became a zombie. And I sat there and I was like, oh my God, like, okay, really? He's one zombie. What can he do in a prison? Just one zombie. But I didn't take in consideration that this happens at nighttime and everyone is asleep. So in the beginning of this episode, you find Patrick walking around. He's like, you know, he's doing the old zombie thing. And he takes a guy right in the throat. So the guy has no way of screaming. And you're like, dude, that's freaking crazy. So anyway, you wind up seeing a whole bunch of people in the cell block getting all infected. And I think there was maybe a total of about 15 people altogether that wound up getting infected. And Rick and the group had to take out these zombies. And this was the first major attack that they have had in a very long time. And you just, again, I said it last week on our live show that you can't take things for granted. This episode was probably the best episode I have seen in a long time. It kept you at the edge of your seat the entire episode. You are wondering what's going to happen with this virus, because we found out that Patrick was really sick. And after a discussion between all the all the characters in The Walking Dead, like Herschel and Rick and everyone, they found out that Patrick was sick and he had this type of virus. And in the last episode, we found out that the pig was sick too. So it was some type of swine flu or whatnot that's infecting, all the community, if you want to call it now. And certain people are going to have to be quarantined. They're going to have to be put in different cell blocks in order to, until they actually find out what's happening or how to solve this sickness or whatnot. This episode was really interesting with that. It's a totally different outtake from the comic book. So there's nothing really to compare from the comic anymore. And I think that's pretty cool how the show has branched off in its own direction. The only similarities that I see at this point to the comic in the show right now is your characters. And we get to see an introduction to a couple of new girls in here. There was a father who got killed in this, you know, of what happened in the jail. And I think his name was Nick, I think. And he had two daughters. And he actually talked to Carol and he said, you know what? I need you to take care of these daughters for me. That's basically what he said before he died. And one daughter is a little on the wacky side, and she's the young daughter. And then there's this other daughter that's on the sane side, and she's like a chicken shit. So these two daughters remind me, if you fans of The Walking Dead remember these characters in the series, in the actual comic book series, these daughters remind me of the twins that were in the comic book series. One went crazy and wound up killing, I think, his twin brother. This is what these kind of kids remind me of. So I don't know if they're going to kind of follow that or not, but that's what they reminded me of. A few other character developments that we found up in here was Bethany, how she winds up being like a mother figure. Really, the women in The Walking Dead now are very strong. Michonne. You get to see a different side of her. They're breaking down the walls with her by holding the baby or whatnot. So you get to see that. You get to see trust issues being developed between Rick and his son Carl again. So lots of great stuff that are happening in this episode. I'm trying to think of some other things too that I can't quite remember. Another part of the thing that happened in this episode was they're trying to figure out who else got sick. And we're thinking about it here, and if you listen to the show correctly, they said that it was like, oh, it looks like the pigs got sick or whatever, and it looks like the humans actually got the pigs sick, and then the pigs wound up getting the humans sick. So that's kind of the way it was going there. And then there's someone feeding the walkers, which is really creepy. They're feeding them rats. Not sure who that person is, but I'm sure we'll find out soon. It could be Bethany for all I'm thinking. It might be her. Really great action scenes in this episode when it comes to the walkers going on top of the fence, and you know, when Rick coming to this realization that, hey man, this ain't no walk in the park. This is real, and we gotta get real again. So again, that's part of the reason why I think Carl and Rick wound up, you know, getting their guns back or whatnot. So very exciting episode. Again, lots of character development. Tyrese winds up losing his little love interest that he had. The ending was very interesting. Kind of leaves you with a head scratcher, finding out what's going to happen here. And this is a totally different outtake on the TV show, and I'm truly enjoying it. It's nice to see some zombie action. It's nice to see that the storyline is staying within right now, within the group, within the jail cell, and gonna have to fight an infection. It's kind of like the worst case scenario. You have, you know, zombies here that you're fighting against. You find out, you know, you come to some kind of conclusion or thought process to keep them out, and now you got a disease that can kill the people on the inside. So it's just like you can't win no matter how you try. This was a phenomenal episode, one of the best episodes of The Walking Dead in a while. I thought this topped last week's episode, but I look at last week's episode as, you know what, The Walking Dead is back. You should be excited. There's going to be great things to come, and this episode proved it. So I cannot wait for the rest of the season. So guys, tell me what you thought about this. Did you like this episode? Was this one of the better episodes for you? Who was your favorite character in this episode? Who's feeding those freaking, you know, zombies and shit? So really crazy stuff. So I really enjoyed this one. So guys, again, give me your thoughts. And guys, until the next comic book review, fans, thank you for watching Comic Book Corner 2.0. And this is Mike Spider Slayer signing off. I'll see you guys real soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.